Rock and roll's not meant to be, it's not for the faint-hearted, is it? You know what I mean? It's a serious business.
He sings, he swears, he hates his brother. That is the Liam Gallagher we know, but this year has been a huge turning point for the one-time Oasis lead singer. After the end of Oasis, a bad divorce and a dead-end side project, it seemed like Liam Gallagher's career was, at the very least, winding down. But instead, he dropped a new album that has gone platinum, he's racked up a stack of award nominations and won new fans all around the world. So we sat down to talk abusive parents, Manchester and music.
Liam, I'm Mark.
Good.
Lovely to meet
Liam,
you.
Liam, nice to meet you.
Thanks so much for your time.
Yeah, mate.
So what's the dumbest question you've ever been asked?
The dumbest question?
Yeah.
I guess, like, the Oasis thing, when's Oasis getting better? It's nothing to do with me, it's not in my hands. It's all in Noel's hands, you know what I mean? He's the one that's there. Not playing ball, so people sort of think that I'm the one who's stopping it, you know what I mean? It's totally not that.
So if it's all in his court, why is he not?
Because I don't think he's got it in him anymore to play the songs. I don't think he's a rock and roll as he likes to make out. I think he wants to be a different artist, you know what I mean? Which is fine, you know what I mean? He doesn't owe me anything and I don't owe him anything. He doesn't owe the fans anything and if you're not feeling it, you're not feeling it, you know what I mean?
So it sounds like you actually really understand his reasons why he doesn't
matter. I get it, man, I get it. But the reasons that he says to the press is because he can't work with me because I'm a bit of a dickhead. Well, I'm not. He's more of a dickhead, you know what I mean? Liam can't do it anymore. I've just fucking proved it. I do it standing on my head, mate, you know what I mean? So he likes all the attention and he knows when he comes to stand next to me, he's like a wallflower, you know what I mean?
Mm. It's a complicated dynamic, isn't it?
Very complicated. I wouldn't wish it on anyone. But it's fun as well.
Do you have to be a little bit angry to be a good rock star? Is there some element of that?
Completely, man. Don't know where it comes from. I mean, listen, my dad was a bit of a dickhead and that.
He was pretty abusive, though, wasn't he?
Yeah. So it was pretty hard, but you get over it. I mean, that was when I was about 8 or 9, so I've been here 45 years, so you learn to get over it.
Your brothers are a fair bit older than you, though. They caught the brunt of it, didn't they? So what do you reckon the difference in impact for you and for them was? Because if they copped the brunt of it and you kind of at the tail end of it.
Yeah, I didn't cop anything. But, you know, even if, like, people go like, you know, listen, it's terrible what happens when they're in abusive families and all that stuff, but watching it can just be as bad as copping for it, you know what I mean?
How do you mean?
Well, if you're seeing something abusive, you know what I mean? All right, the abuse is getting done to someone else and obviously it's terrible for that person and that, but watching it's equally as mad, you know what I mean, as mental, you know what I mean, or it can be just as bad, you know what I mean, even though you're not physically getting a dig, you've seen it, you know what I mean, so, yeah, it was shit times growing up, but truth hurts, doesn't it, sometimes, you know what I mean.
You're a parent now.
Mm.
Do you actively...
They don't listen to a word I say, man. I haven't got a leg to stand on, have I?
I'd say,
don't be doing that. Treat that girl like that. I'm like, don't be treating her like a dickhead. Well, you can't talk. Don't be doing them drugs. You can't talk. Don't be fighting that geezer. You can't. I just like that. Get on with it.
So how do you find your way through it, though? Because you've got a few of them.
I go on tour and leave them to it.
That's the solution?
I don't know, man. Listen, because I have done pretty much a lot of things. I've had a colourful life, and I think that's a good thing. So you can turn around and say, listen, if you do get into any of that kind of shit, come and have a word and that.
Mm. And what would you say?
I don't know, man. I mean, I just say, look, common sense, innit?
What do you reckon you've taken from it? I mean, there has been a lot of, you know, there was assaults and I think you were banned from an airline or two. Like, what do you take away from
it? Yeah, but the assault was like, I think it was justice. I know the law doesn't say that, but the geezer put a camera in my face and I told him not to. You know what I mean? It's personal fucking space, you know what I mean? And I asked him, I said, look, don't put the camera. And he kept doing it. He'd been drinking, I'd been drinking, so we copped for it. So, you know, I know that's not allowed in law and that in England and in Australia, but I was in my rights, mate, so, and I'd do it all over again. Just wanna fly, wanna live, but don't wanna die. Maybe I just wanna breathe. Maybe I just don't believe. Maybe you performed at that incredible concert in Manchester, the One Love concert. Why was it important for you to do that? Because it's my hometown, and I think obviously you want to show people that you care, and you're not in it for the money, and it's not all about hits and big houses and flash cars and drugs. You know, you got to put it back. Maybe I will never be all the things that
on stage is where I'm completely 100% in control of me, you know what I mean? Where you get one chance to do the song justice and everyone just in the moment, you know what I mean?
What's for you the song that you have sung that you reckon the audience misunderstand?
I mean, I don't even know what they're about, to be fair. And I don't. And that's the beauty of music. I think everything, a lot of people, I hate it when people turn around and go, oh, it's about this and it's about that. Not everything has to have a meaning.
Yeah.
I think that as soon as you tell someone it's about that, they stop exploring, you know what I mean?
That's interesting.
And I think that's a bit of a shame. So I don't know what they're about. I don't know what Wonderwall's about. I don't know what any of it's about. I don't want to know what they're about.
This new album has been, it's funny when you call it your first solo album, because it feels weird to say it's your first solo album because you've been performing for a quarter of a century here. The day it came out, were you nervous? Because it's all on you at that moment.
I'm nervous in the fact that maybe this was kind of the last roll of the dice kind of thing, because I don't know whether people are tuning in or not, you know what I mean? So it depends on whether the people are there at the right time and they're listening. There's been a lot of good albums that come out by great people, and it just doesn't happen, you know what I mean?
Were you prepared for that to happen if it had?
What was I prepared? I would have knocked it on the head, man. I wouldn't have gone, you can't flog a dead horse, you know what I mean? I'm certainly not going to put myself through it again and go and do another one. I'll just quietly, or maybe not quietly, but sort of just trickle off in the corner and go and do something else, maybe. I feel like if I've got another crack at the whip, another chance, so you just want to, you don't want to abuse it, you know what I mean? Whereas with Oasis, when we first started, you know what I mean, we just wanted to have a good time, you know what I mean? And before you know it, we got really big quick and, you know, I guess we did a lot of stupid things and that, but once that's gone, you kind of go, fucking hell, I wish I'd enjoyed it a bit more. So the main thing is just to live in the moment, be here now, you know what I mean? Live in the, don't be thinking about the second album or the third. Enjoy what you're doing now, you know what I mean? And live it and feel it. We'll cross that bridge when we come to it.
Liam, thank you. A legend. Thanks so much for talking to us.
You're welcome.